Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BUVU Gaming, and today we are back in Valheim, and after the last episode, I kind of went up and picked up some of the stuff up here from this shelter, and we had something stored somewhere here. I picked that up. Some of it I have left here because I didn't have enough room, so things like some resin and stone and stuff like that I just left behind, and I can always go and pick it up later if I really need something like that. Or if I pass by and I have room anyway, there we go, now we have our spawn point set back here. But what we're gonna do right now is to try and make something out of this troll hide. So let's see. Okay, we can make the troll leather tunic, which actually only takes 5, so we could make both of these, right? Gives us armor 6 compared to armor 4. For both the tunic and the pants, and weight is 5, that's the same, durability is the same. These of course are level 2, these are level 1. The pants give us 6 as well, and then there is the cape, but that would use up all our troll hides. We do need some bone fragments, which I do have, but it only gives us armor 1 compared to armor 3. Of course this is a level 3, so, or quality 3. Durability is the same though, but right now I don't really use the sneaking that much. So I'm kind of thinking, I think for now let's make these, because that gives me more armor. That's a pure upgrade, right? So let's do this, and of course they're only a level 1, so we can upgrade these more when we get more troll height. There we go, lovely. Okay, so let's see. Gonna equip this. Oh, very nice. I do like this little detail that you can see the armor. I'm not usually that focused on that much, my character and what he or she looks like, but it is kind of a little cool little detail, because there's so many games where they choose to go for first person just to avoid this, so that you don't actually really see your character, right? So it's just a little bonus that you can actually do that. You know what? I think we're gonna start using this over here for all these things. All our extra armor and weapons and things, because I start building up a supply of these. Okay, so now we have that, and then I think we're gonna test out a few things, because you guys left some comments, and one of them was that apparently you can catch fish by hand. Ooh, can I get that deer over there, because I always need more deer hides. So let's see. Yes. Nice. Let's grab this. And okay, wow. There's definitely some a decent knockback on this maze, right? But I think it was also 80 or something compared to like 20 or 30 on the old one. There we go. So we got a little bit more goodies. Let's grab this. And usually I have some fish over here. I actually found some more fish right on the shore here yesterday. So we have some fishies out there. Let's see if we can find a shallow spot to stand on. Because I'm probably going to start swimming out at this level. But maybe I can stand here. Yeah, something like this. Looks like we're standing. And then I assume it's E that you have to use, and then you should just kind of, you know, it takes a lot of patience, but it would in real life too. See if they will actually come close. You could probably also try and see if you could do it, hit one with a spear or something, but I was told that you should be able to catch them by hand. So let's see if anyone wants to come close enough that I can actually do that. Oh, now I'm swimming again. That's not good. You guys gonna come over here? Might have to go and poke around over near that rock there. Yeah, I keep swimming because of the waves. Doesn't look like you'll have much interest in coming over here. So I think we're gonna try and go over here. See if we can find a spot here to stay. If we stand here, for instance, let's try that and see if someone is gonna pass by us. Oh, nope. Okay. Come on, little ones. Of course, now it's starting to get dark. Nope. I don't think I really have much patience for this approach, but I really had to test it out, right? Just to see if it is a thing. But they're not very willing to come close. Come on, fishies. And there might be... There might be better... Come on. Nope. Might be better spots if you can find somewhere that is like really, really... Okay, E is definitely not doing anything yet. Left click doesn't really work. Okay, so I would assume it's E you have to use, but it might be something else. Okay, those waves are making it really, really hard to just stand here. Okay, that's definitely too far away. Not getting any pop-up or anything. Okay, so pressing E on you didn't actually do anything. Okay, so I'm not quite sure how that would work. Okay, I keep swimming and then I put that away. That's a little... Okay, it's gonna be really hard to see anything like that. I was trying to see if I could maybe try and throw my spear, but the second I do this, then I can't really see where the fish is, and I kind of need to do that to aim at them, right? So, unless you just stand like this, and then you just need to get them close enough that you can poke them. Come on, fishies. Oh, now we're swimming again. Man. No. Oh, it's because now I don't have it equipped again. Nope. I don't have the patience for that. But apparently, you I'm told that you should be able to. I think that was Kuhn living, who said that you can catch them by hand, but. What key are you supposed to use for that? I don't think I really have the patience for that, but pressing E definitely didn't seem to work, and well, if you left click, you just kind of hit, so I'm not quite sure that's the key either. Maybe you have to use a different key, right? So yeah, I think I'm gonna need a few more details on that. Okay, got one. Okay, so it's gonna get dark. So I was thinking that I have heard that you are supposed to be able to tame boars, and it did say on one of those stones as well that you should be able to catch them, right, or tame them or something. So and I think Rena said something about them being good pets or something. So. I think that is something I also want to try and figure out how that works. Let's keep these. So it said something about roots of the ground or something. So maybe it's the mushrooms that we need. Let's bring some berries as well, right? Here we go. What else do we have? We do have some dandelions. What would they eat? I would think mushrooms. I would think mushrooms, right? It might not be it, but we're gonna try. So let's just drop this stuff off. Just like that. And then it said something about walking really slow or walking slowly on that stone where we read about them. I think there's still a couple. There were a couple out here. Yeah, they are down there. They are still down there. I saw them yesterday, so I figured I would leave them so we could kind of test this out. But usually when I go near them, they run. They attack me, right? So, but it did say something about going slow. So maybe if you sneak, you can do something. We can't really hold this in our hand per se, can we? Okay, let's try and split this up a little bit. There we go. Right. And just have a few. I have no idea what we're gonna need. Let's take you. I don't know if you're just, but if I mark that like 5, well, maybe you get a pop-up so you can just press 5 and then try and feed it, or maybe you have to throw it on the ground or something. I don't know. But I think that's what we're gonna try. And otherwise, I'm thinking about trying to build some kind of pen and see if I can lure them in there and then mess around with it. But let's first go in here and sleep because it's gonna get dark now. So let's just do this so that we can actually see what's going on. Okay, because I could try to build something out here, just a little thing, because I can easily kill them. I can like one shot them with a spear or something, so it's not really a problem bringing them inside our base, and it might make some things easier. So let's just try and take this and bring this up a little bit. I kind of got this mined out a little too far because I'm planning on mining it out further, right? But right now it's like this. Just want to make sure that, what if I path it? What does that do? Can we walk up this? I just want to make sure that they will actually follow me, right? So what if we, right, we need some stone. Just grab this. I have no idea what I'm doing, guys, as usual. But we're just gonna try and see if we can figure this out. Here we go. And let's grab you. It shouldn't be too steep this at all, but here we go. And then we're gonna, oh, I still don't have enough. Man, okay. Well, I have plenty of stone. I have plenty of stone over here. Well, I have a full chest of it, and now I have started to fill this up as well. Need to make more storage for it somewhere, or put it like this, right? So let's just try to raise that a bit. There we go. So now we have a little bit more of a natural slope here. It's not so good to have this open, but I don't really think there's anything that's gonna crawl underneath that. And then we could build. Let's try and do that. Let's try and do that. So in case it doesn't work when you get out there, then we can kind of try and lure them back here. So let's grab a bit of wood like this, and then we're just gonna try and build something temporary here. Because the thing I'm wondering about is the fact that they usually attack me, so this might be a complete waste. I might not have to do this, but let's just try and do something. So we'll be coming in there, right? It is just kind of a temporary thing. Put that here, there, there. Okay. Should probably be bigger, but let's just do it like this. Ooh. Yep. And come on. Like that. And then let's put not a gate, but a little door in something over here. And then maybe a door here so we can get out on the other side. This reminds me of playing Ark. there we go, right? And then we can kind of run through here. Probably gonna take a few hits, but it shouldn't really matter with these guys. I can take a lot of hits from them without dying. At least if we make sure to eat first, right? That's always a good idea. Just heal up a little bit. And let's put a mushroom. Well, I don't know if that's what they eat. It might be the berries. It might be the dandelions, something. Let's leave that open for the time being. I don't see any other creatures. Where did they go? Oh, there we go. Let's move this. Okay, so let's see. We have one here. I think there's a second one somewhere. And then I'm going to be ready to press 5. But I think as soon as I get too close, it's gonna attack me. Okay, wild and hungry. At least as long as I'm sneaking, it's not really It's not attacking me. Okay. Hey, but I'm not getting a pop-up, so pressing 5 will just... You can't eat more mushroom, yeah. Okay, so what if I go over next to you and do this? Can I do that? Oh. Oops. Let's try that again. Oh! Yikes! I think I stood up. That's not good. You gonna attack me again? Oh, you're still gonna attack me. Okay, I think we're gonna try... If I can get you to follow me. Come on. Come on. Yes. Come on. Come on, little one. Yeah, it's okay. I know. I know. You're a wild animal, right? So... Come on. Can I get you to follow me in here? Whoop. Okay, so we got you that far. Don't run back out. Come here. Come here. Yes. Come with me. Okay, let's close the gate. If we can lure you in here. And we're gonna have to mess around a little bit, so come on. Yep. There we go, got that closed. And that closed. Okay, so now we have a boar. Which of course are gonna be attacking everything. So let's see, let's make some ladders. Okay, so was it just because I failed at throwing this somewhere, or do you just don't like mushrooms? Okay, let's try and throw some berries down there. Let's try and throw some mushrooms down there. Okay. Well, it might have to come down. I might have to let it come down. Okay. Oh, look at that! Looks like... Was that berries? I think you ate the berries because I threw 2 berries in there, right? Okay, you're still not too happy. But you can still eat, right? So let's just make sure to do this. How much damage are you doing? Not much. I can barely even see that it's... There's only a little bit of damage. So let's just do this. Oh, look at that. We got another heart. Ew. Did you eat the mushrooms this time then? Or are you tame now? Ah, you don't really look tame, do you? Still looks a little bit... I wonder if you ate some of the mushrooms. I should have put them down like one by one, shouldn't I? Okay, let's just try. Ooh, tameness. 2% acclimatizing. Okay, 13. Okay, now we're frightened. Okay, so I think you can eat both. Oh, make sure to close that. So, let's do this. And then we're going to split these up so that I can actually see what you're doing. Nope. Here we go. Just going to throw them down. Here we go. Let's try and do a mushroom. Just because I think you ate one of those as well. So, let's try and throw one of those down there and see if we can get you to eat it. Because one of the berries definitely disappeared, so here we go. And let's throw this down there. Okay, now we have a little bit of food. Something is definitely happening. Okay, but that's gonna take a while because that was 2%, right? So we're gonna have to try and bring another one in here. And I don't know what happens once it's tame, if you can use it as like a pet in combat, which I kind of feel a little bit bad about doing in this game, which is kind of odd because I have played World of Warcraft, for instance, and my favorite character there would be a hunter, because you have pets, right? But I'm more thinking, but actually you could feel a little bit bad because I suspect that you can tame or breed these somehow if you have more than one, right? And then you would kind of, then you have an unlimited supply of meat and leather. that way by killing some of them all the time, right? I would assume that's how it works anyway. So I almost could see, still kind of a little, okay, 6%. Okay, so that's gonna take a while. You do have a little bit of food there. They should stay a while. Let's put another mushroom down there, and then we're just gonna go and do something else for a little bit and come back and see how it's going. So let's do this, and oh, they end up the same place, but that's okay. Nice, because things at least stay for a couple of days, so it should be fine. At least from what I've noticed, when you drop something somewhere, then you can find it even a few days later. That's gonna last for a long time. So we might have to make a better enclosure. I don't know if we can actually get this to follow us once it's tame, but I guess we'll find out. Otherwise, we can kill it and tame another one and build a proper enclosure, right? So anyway, while we're waiting for that, let's just drop off a few things. I don't know if I have to be close while it's taming up, that's another thing. But I did get another comment from Roman about these. Well, you still have hats coming up over there, so that's good. Let's see. That apparently you can dig in a certain area and find goodies. And we passed one up here, which he referred to as looking like a fossilized ship hull. I'm gonna have to get a look at it again. I was kind of checking my video to make sure I knew where it was, because we passed by it on the way to the first troll 2 videos ago. But it should be right up here in this opening. Yes, I have some trees here. I ran out of storage space. I was out cutting down those birch trees that were here. Okay, so must be, let's see, there's a shell. Yeah, we came up this way because that's the first troll, right? So it should be right up here in this opening. And there we go. And keep running out of, okay, 6, 7, 8. Ooh. Always need more hides. Lovely. And more meat. We can always use that, right? Okay, so let's see. Yeah, this thing over here, I think that is what Roman was referring to. Now I can see why you meant a fossilized ship hull, because it's so big. I was actually thinking about it when I first read the comment about another place where I feel like I saw some that were only like a small part like this. But apparently you're supposed to be able to find something in here if you dig in this area. Wow, that's gonna take a lot of digging. It is a bit bigger than I thought, but that's okay. Let's start by removing this. And I'm just gonna try and dig out the ground and see if we find something. What is this? I don't know. Okay, so if we start here, right? I have no idea how deep or if there's a specific place within this where you can find something, but at least I'm gonna get a whole bunch of stone out of this, right? Just trying to stay within the stones. And oh, look at that! Very cool! Oh, what is this? Oh, we found a silver necklace! Valuable! Value 30, weight 0.1. Oh, I can't even equip it. But we got it, and we got some amber pearls. Oh, that's very nice! Cool, can you find more? Okay, I'm just gonna try and mine out some more, because I don't know if you can find more than one chest here. Or if there's only one. There might only be one, that would kind of make sense, right? But let's just check it. Okay, so there's also this. Look at this. Skeletal remains pick up. So, I don't know. Maybe there's more stuff underneath. Let's just see. But so far I haven't found anything over there. But okay, we can pick this up. Very cool. I love this. This is very, very, very nice. It's proper treasure hunting, right? So here we go. We could well, I guess this is like a it's a burial site actually. We're kind of grave robbers. That would make sense, right? That this would be kind of a burial site, and I do get the idea with the fossilized ship hull kind of deal. Well, it could be a ship, but it could also be like a burial site where they illustrate this to be like a ship. Because it's a Viking that is buried here, right? That would kind of make sense. Okay, so my pickaxe is kind of getting worn out, but I don't think there is anything else here. I might be wrong, but I don't think there is. It's probably all kind of very close to the chest once you find that. But that was cool. Very nice tip. Okay, so my pickaxe is used up. Now we have this little chest. Very cool. Haha. Okay, so we're gonna have to mark that. So let's see, what are we gonna mark you as? We're gonna call you. Here we go. Well, to me it's a burial site. It makes sense to me that it would be a burial site, so we're gonna call it that. Like this. And I know I've seen more of these places where there's these stones that are kind of suspicious in the way they have been placed, so we're gonna have to keep an eye out for those. But for now, let's go back and check on our little boar, right? Ooh, and as I was going back, look at this place, guys. We've got another one. Ooh. Oh, yeah. Okay, and I actually have a little birch log there. Okay, well, we're gonna try and dig this out as well, but that means I am gonna need... Do I have any wood on me? Not much. Not much. I need... How far away from home are we? Home is down there. Well, we could just kind of build something. Right, we need... What do we need? We need 10 logs or 10 wood for our workbench, and then we need a little bit so we can make... we can just use this, right? Oh, there's bees in here. Oh. Okay, so somehow I managed to hit that. I just wanted to remove this because we just need to have a little bit of roof. Here we go. So that we can place a workbench. Just gonna leave those bees for now. Here we go, and then we can repair things, right? Lovely. Okay, let's try and dig out this place. Ooh, a one star. Yep, here we go. Give me the goodies. And then I'm gonna try and dig this out and see if I can find a chest here as well and see what's in that one. I like the necklace. I assume eventually we're gonna be able to sell that. Oh, haha, that was easy. That was easy. Okay, so we found some rubies and some coins, because there's also coins. So there must be some way that you can do something. Well, if it's implemented, that's the case, of course. But there must be a way to sell and buy things, and I noticed all those amber and ruby pearls and things, and we found the skeletal remains. So I think that's all there is here. But we found another one. That is so cool. Lovely. I'm so gonna go treasure hunting when out exploring. There we go. Burial site. Mark you. And now let's home. Let's head home again. So yeah, I think I didn't even finish my sentence because I got distracted, but the amber pearls and all these rubies and things, it kind of sells a value, right? And that it's valuable, so it's probably just something you can sell. The same for these. I don't know if there's anything you can craft with it, but it seems like it's something you can just sell. And same for the silver necklace, right? So that is a very cool. Let's go and check on our little friend over here. See how we're doing. I only see one mushroom down there, so Or is there two? It's really hard to see in the dark here. How are we doing here on you? Just... Ooh, 12% frightened. Okay, so that's gonna be a while, guys. That's gonna be a little while. But then I can just chill out a bit. And while waiting for that... There we go. Okay, so I just caught a second one. Just made a little extra piece here so that I could bring it in here, and then I can kind of remove some of this to bring them together, which I assume is going to be fine, just because I want to see how that's going to work. So there we go. Look at that. Very nice. Okay, so let's see if the second one... So you're wild and you're frightened. So hopefully it will eat something, right? Let's just see what happens. Okay, let's go and sleep while they mess around with that. And okay, stop crouching. here we go. Take a little nap. Oh, you're still wild and frightened. Okay. Well, it didn't really... It's not a lot of time that passed, right? Because I was... busy sleeping. But here we go. Let's throw in some more food. But now they both have... Well, one... It looked like they both had like a little... Yeah, that one. Oh, there we go. Now we have hearts on both of them. Well, you're still kind of wild and frightened, so I don't know how that works, but you're 28. I hope the one that's going to be tamed first is not going to kill the other one, but that's what we're going to find out, right? You're still wild and frightened. Okay, why are you not wanting to... Oh, now you have a heart. Okay, I think they're both taming up, so... We're just gonna wait, and then we're gonna see how that turns out, right? Okay, so we are getting closer here, at least for one of them. Last I checked, it was at 90%. Oh, I didn't see what that was, 70-something maybe? Yeah, 94%. So you are gonna be tamed very, very soon. They do eat something every now and then. I think they eat both mushrooms and berries. I'm not 100% sure, but I do think so. I don't know if you have to keep feeding them once they're tamed, or it's like, okay, now they're tame and that's it. But I guess we'll find out, right? But I thought while we're waiting for that, let's try and test out this thing with the teleports. I was also kind of messing around with this up here, because you do have to do a lot of repairing on this all the time. If you have something like this, I've just repaired everything, but in a couple of days they're going to be half broken again. So I figured, okay, let's try and set up something like this, which I actually kind of like. It would make sense if you had guards. Of course, that's only me, right? But if you had guards wandering around up here, you would have some kind of coverage so they don't have to stand in the rain and things like that. So I think I kind of actually like this thing here. And of course I had to bring the pillars all the way down to make sure I had enough support, because otherwise I could only put one little piece of roof up there, and nothing else actually, because they wouldn't have much support. But by having them all the way down, I can actually still only put two, and then I have to have the pillars. But I kind of like the way it looks. So I think that's something I'm gonna go with. I could try and pull this back a little bit. I could raise it if I want to have it going over this, but I haven't really decided. It was just something I was messing around with. So you can see there's a piece there I haven't missed. And then of course I would have to do the same thing on the inside, so we kind of have another one over here, right, covering this entire piece. But yeah, we'll see. I think that's the idea anyway for now. So quickly, let's check on... Okay, 73%. 99, you're almost tame. Yeah, I'm kind of curious if they will attack each other. which if this one is tame then this one is not. I would not really expect them to, because otherwise it's gonna get really tricky if you have to keep them separate, and it is kind of easier if you can tame more than one at a time, right? But that, I think it's that one should be tame really, really soon. Oh, boar has been tamed. Oh, nice. Okay, so that one will still take a while, but at least we have one right now, right? Let's see if we can get over and get a little bit of a look at it to see what it sells when it's tamed. Oh, tame, happy. Oh, we can pet it. Bear loves you. Oh, I love it. That is so cool. Okay, so we can pet it, but I don't know. It doesn't seem like it has any options for, like, I want you, or making it follow you or something. But I think the idea is to, once this is tame, we can probably breed them somehow and get more. And that way we have meat and leather, right? I assume that's how it works. Okay, so they've definitely eaten up the berries over there. They still have some more berries over here, but I do think they're still eating the mushrooms here as well. Oh, this is so cool! Okay, well, figured that out. So before we end this, I kind of wanted to test out one last thing. So I have everything here I need to make a couple of portals. And I assume we can just remove them again. But otherwise, we're going to find out right now if we can't. So we're just going to try and pop one down right there. Okay, and... Ooh, hello! Portals are great for fast travel between different parts of the world. Of course, you need to build one on the other end as well. Then give the pair the same name and they will be automatically connected. Okay, so we can give it a portal tag. Okay, so if I say we call you home, right? So portal tag home. Can I just change it again? Yeah, we can. Okay, so... Portal tag home. So now we have one portal there, and then I actually wanted to test this out before I make another one here. I wanted to see if we can just kind of break this. Let's just go over here so we can see what we're doing. Can I just break it? I hope I can just... Yeah, it does get marked when I do this, so... Oh, okay. Fine wood, 10 grow. Yeah, okay, so you get everything back. We can just remove it again. Cool, cool, cool. So let's try and put you there, right? Again. And then we are going to go here and say this is just going to be home. Eventually, I'm going to have these somewhere else. I just wanted to try and see if I could figure out how it works. So now we have a second one, and hopefully I can place it right here. And, okay, portal tag unconnected. So... If we call this home as well. I don't know if it works. Ooh. Ooh. Okay, portal tech home connected. Portal tech home connected. Why does this one not kind of... Oh, maybe it only does... Oh, when I go going close. Ah, oh. You just walk into it. I wasn't expecting that. I thought I had to, like, click it or something. Okay, but it worked. Look at that. I don't know why this one looks so amazing and this one doesn't. See, this one is glow. Oh. Oh, you have to stand on this side. Right. Okay, so it looks like you come out on the side that is this kind of glowing one. Oh, look at that. That looks so cool. Okay, so the thing is... Since you can change the tag, we could just have one here called home, and then we can bring the materials with us. We can place one potentially up here somewhere, right? Maybe all the way up here. Then we change the tag on that one to home, and then we can jump right back and drop off resources, anything but oils. There might be other things we can't carry, but it seems to be... I didn't know what that meant in the beginning. Can you carry the metal bars? No, you can't carry the metal bars either. So this is what it means. I didn't know what this little icon meant. It does say can't be teleported. But I think that's what this icon means, right? It kind of looks like a teleport with a crossover weight. So I think that's what it means. Oh, that is so cool. But I'm kind of thinking... Because you could do that if you're just... exploring and not doing any mining. You could just have the materials with you, pop a portal down when your inventory is full, pop right back, or pop back and empty your inventory, pop right back to the portal again, right? And then you could break it and take it with you. That would work. But if you have more than one portal, like if I want to leave a portal up here and then I make another portal over here, then I would want that one to be changed to something. If I put a portal here and use it to go back, then I have to call it home, right? Which means that's already called home. If I then adventure out this way and put another portal over here, then I have to call that home too. But how does it know if I want to go there or there if these are both called home? So I guess if it's the final place you want to place it, then you have to make sure you leave it on foot and leave it with the right name, right? Or you're going to want to make like a portal hub or something where you have like portals for different destinations. So I have several portals here and then each of them lead to different destinations. I'm kind of thinking that might be what I want to do. So I set up more portals and then I have one that leads to here, for instance, one that leads to here. I don't know how many places I want to have it. And then I could have one portal that was just like a, you know, to go explore. So you have one that doesn't really have a specific name, but you change it every time, right? Or that could just be the home one. And then you have one that you bring with you and then you pop it down and just take it with you wherever you go, and then you can put one more permanently at some point. Well, I don't know, I'm rambling. That's definitely something to figure out, but for the time being we have them, we can start using them, so that is really, really cool. You guys probably already figured out exactly how all that works, but I just wanted to see if they could work, because then we can bring some of this with us next time, right? Let's have a quick little look and see if... Okay, I don't think the other one is quite tame yet, because I haven't gotten any pop-up about it. Okay, that must be you. Okay, 96% frightened, right? Tame, happy. Okay, I'm just gonna wait and see what happens once this one is fully tamed. Okay, so they definitely eat both the berries and the mushrooms, because I just saw the berries over here disappear a while ago, and now it ate the mushrooms. So they do eat both. They might eat other things too, I don't know. But at least now we know there's two kinds of food that you can feed them. Ooh, look at that! Lovely! Yeah! Nice, now we have two... So you are happy and you are happy. Cool. Okay, let's try and leave those berries here, because I want to see if... Okay, we have 12 raspberries. Let's just stand kind of... Oh. Oh, I think they're doing things. I think they are doing things, guys. Okay, well, let's just leave it there and then we can see if it disappears, because I don't know. Well, I'm gonna have to go around and check them. But... There was like some happiness stuff. Well, you're hungry, so it does look like you have to keep feeding them. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Yeah, look at that. You're gonna go and eat. That's nice. But they did have like little love hearts things. So I'm kind of curious if we're gonna have a little baby here at some point. I don't know if you can... Well, I would assume you can breed them. So I guess we're gonna wait and see. But now we have two. Right? Oh, this is so much fun, guys. I love all this and figuring things out. That's the best part of these types of games to me. That's just so much fun. Okay, but that was it for today. A lot of experimenting, messing around and things. And then we're going to see what we're going to do next time. We do have that ship that I want to make, the Cave. And I am kind of pondering if we should try and make it just sail around. And see if we can get up here, kind of see how long that's going to take. Because we did have some land really, really close here. I think this is pretty close, but not as close over here. So I probably want to go up there. I could also just carry it, you know, the materials, and then plop it down over here. But I kind of want to test out how it works. So that's why I'm probably going to sail the long way. I might also come up with something completely different next time. Knowing me, I change my mind all the time, guys. So thank you so much for watching, and as always, do take care and happy gaming.